in elementary. Thrived on misery, left me alone. I grew up amongst the dying breed. Inside my mind, couldn't find a place to rest until I got that thug life tatted on my chest. Tell me, can you feel me? I'm not living in the past. You wanna last? Be the first to blast. Remember Cato? No longer with the seat, the seats. Calling the sirens. Seen them murdered in the streets. Now rest in peace. Is there heaven for a G? Remember me? So many homies in the cemetery shed so many tears. I suffered through the years and shed so many tears. Lord, I lost so many peers and shed so many tears. Now I'm struggling in this business by any means. Label me greedy, getting green, but seldom seen. The world, cause I'm cursed. I'm having visions of leaving here in the hearse. God, can you feel me? Take me away from all the pressure and all the pain. Show me some happiness again. I'm going blind. I spend my time in the cell. Ain't living well. I know my destiny is hell. But did I fail? My life is in denial. And when I die, baptized in eternal fire, shed so many tears. Lord, I suffered through the years and shed so many tears.
Hey, greetings black family, the streets watching, always keeping our eyes open and scoping. Listen, I'm gonna make this short and acute. I don't want to, you know, drawing y'all out on this same subject, because us from the streets and all people, whether black, Puerto Rican, no matter what color you are, we all know something that's going on in this country that's very strange at this moment with the coronavirus. But besides the coronavirus, we know politically that something is not right, and we catching on. In the past, I think we was all blinded by celebrities, and the politicians can use celebrities to win your vote. So this video is about Kansas Owens and Cardi B. What I'm saying, we as a people can't get caught up in the feud between those two, because you know they're going back and forth. They're only going at it because of politics. Trust me. It's nothing more than politics. These two sisters would probably meet somewhere and have a formal conversation and agree on certain things, and be at the end of the day, they'd be friends, because at the end of the day, it's just the rich against those don't have nothing, which is called the have-nots. And at the end of the day, it's all about if you're rich or if you broke, middle class, no matter what. If you're black, at the end of the day, it's all about everybody teaming up and pushing the eight ball off the planet. What I mean by the eight ball, when you play pool, the last ball that has to be knocked off the planet or knocked off the pool table to win is the eight ball. So at the end of the day, all the colors at the end of the day are against the black people of this country. And this all started a week ago when Cardi B and Joe Biden had an interview with each other. I don't know what podcast they were on. I don't know what TV show they were on, but I seen some of the clip. And to me, it was an honest interview, even though I know that Cardi B's been used to sway the public and her fans to vote for Joe Biden. We all know that the reason why this interview was happening, because Joe Biden wants black people or a majority of Cardi B fans to vote for him. This all this interview was about. Just like if Trump drop an ad against Biden and Biden drop an ad against him on the television and on, you know, line, we know these ads are trying to cut each other out of the seat. You know, well, Trump already sitting in the seat. He's trying to stay there for 4 more years. Okay. I don't think Cardi B has the right, though, to come out and be disrespectful. I mean, not Cardi B. I'm sorry, y'all. My train of thought. I don't think Kansas Owens has the right to come out and attack Cardi B in a way that she did. She could have came out and said, you know, because she's a Trump supporter. She could have come out and said, well, Black people, don't be fooled. Cardi B is just being used as a tool to get your vote for Biden. Hey, cool. But you got to talk about the woman with, you know, her background and how she came up and she ain't black and, you know, and was just very disrespectful. And I find out it's just politics. You know, this is why I tell you, if you want to get some money today and you don't have no money, all you got to do is get this platform. Like me, I don't get that many views, but I bet if I was a black man that spoke against my people and I was a Donald Trump supporter, my views would go to the ceiling. Black people would even want to sit down and watch me talk about black people. But since I talk about black unity and black love and we should do this as a people, we should move forward as a people, and this is what we should be doing as a people, nobody want to hear black people getting together and loving themselves. There's something wrong with black people loving themselves. It's all right for white people to push European status around the world as being top-notch. It's all right for Puerto Ricans and all other races to worship and love themselves. You know what I mean? But it's wrong for black people. I don't know what's wrong with that. What's wrong with me loving myself and my people? Why is it a crime? Why is it a crime? So what I'm saying is, if you want to get money and your money back, all you got to do is come out and be this color and talk about your people and be a Trump supporter. That's all you have to do. You don't even have to be a Trump supporter. You could be a Democrat like Kamala Harris and date number white men and say that you're Indian and you're not black. Your father was born in Jamaica and he's a black man, but she don't want to be part of that. So all you got to do is denounce the skin that you're in front of white people. They will give you money. They give you a platform. Man, you'll be the guy, or you'll be her. You'll be the queen of black people, and they want you to speak for black people. You know why? Because when you speak against yourself, you're doing white supremacy a big favor, something that they ain't got to go out and do, because they got a jigaboo going out and campaigning and promote white supremacy and black skin to keep the slaves in check. You know, in Christianity, all you good Christian people, y'all don't never study. All y'all do is go off emotions when I speak. They had one nigga, when they opened that Bible up and finally taught a nigga, because a nigga, they had to get a nigga some type of encouragement to stay, stay a course with being nothing but a slave, a robot. So they use religion to keep you as a robot. So they took one Negro from amongst the black folks and made him the preacher. The only thing he could preach out that Bible is to forgive your enemies and love your enemies. Until this day, niggas that I talk to, they love Joe Biden. They love the Democratic Party, like the Democratic Party have done something for black people in the past. But back to Kansas Owens, you had no right to chop Cardi B up the way you chopped her up. But you was for your slave master. Your slave masters. You love your slave masters so much, you like that dog that you can throw rocks at in the streets and get out of here, run. But chase that dog home to his master's doorstep. That dog would turn into Cujo. That same dog that you was kicking around, when that dog gets back to his master's house, it turns into something that you ain't never seen before. And that's what Kansas Owens did for Trump. When Joe Biden sat down with Cardi B, that was an act of war. That's that money bag that Kansas Owens got to get. She said, oh no, I can't let someone of color get out here and have a platform such as Cardi B get out here and speak against Trump. I gotta do something. Boy, she ran head first. Boom, crash. And showed her stupidity again. The more Kansas Owens talked, the more stupid she sounds, and it reveals to me that plantation life is deep. Mental side slavery and psychological slavery, Stockholm syndrome is a real disease. And I'm not being funny, but I kind of feel sorry for sisters like that. And then again, I get mad because, I don't know. I get mad because I'm black, she black, and why would you speak against yourself? In the animal kingdom, you would never see the lion go against a lion for a cheetah, or a cheetah go against the cheetahs for a lion. Even though the lions do fight for territorial position, the males do, but when it's a war against other cats, they all band together. You ain't gonna never see, I hate to go to the animal kingdom, but we all animals if you look at it. We mammals, just like them. And we display some animalistic behavior as black people and white people and people in general. We all kill each other. Asians kill Asians, blacks kill blacks, whites kill whites, but when blacks kill blacks, it's more highlighted because they all want us to feel like we ain't nothing. And the reason why white supremacy highlight our actions because he want everybody around the world to look real low down on black people. But we all, as a people, kill each other. If I lived in a white neighborhood, if I was white, it's homicide going on in that neighborhood, 9 times out of 10, my murderer would be white. So get off that black-on-black crime. That's why I'm speaking for the platform that I'm speaking for. I'm speaking for the streets, strictly for my street niggas. And that's what I'm going to say. Strict. That's why you see me come on here and smoke a blunt. I be come over here acting crazy, but I'm intelligent. I come over here to get to my street niggas. Not to say my street niggas crazy, but I'm going to let them know I can get crazy too, because that's where the platform where I come from. I come from the gutter. And I'm not here to brag about the crimes that I did, because I wreaked havoc on my community selling drugs. I didn't do no gang banging, but I understand street people. Because everybody from the streets ain't stupid. It's some real intelligent entrepreneurs, empire motherfuckers that I done met on the older side, old side, that's raw with this. Mathematically, got good genius technology going on. So don't think street people stupid. Any nigga could take dope and build him a fucking empire. It's not a stupid motherfucker. So I'm not glavinizing none of that shit, but I'm just letting you know I'm speaking from the street, because you hear me cuss, oh, that nigga, he on here just, you know, come on here with no shirt on. I came with my first presentation I made in a long time with no shirt on. My motherfucking air conditioner was fucking out. I took my motherfucking shirt off. I'm being real. I'm being me. You got white boys all on the comments talking about a good dating site. You know, they gay. I'm gonna let you know, man, I'm a heterosexual black man. I love nothing but black women, black queens. Back to what I was saying, Candace Owens don't have no right to chop that sister up the way she chopped that sister up. You know what I mean? And the reason why I call her a sister, because I look at her skin complexion, I look at her features on her face, she got more African strain in her face than the Spanish. And most Spanish speaking people that got dark skin, if you check their DNA and go all the way back, you will find out that they share African trait, an African parent. Because you got to understand, the slave master, he took people to the Caribbean, the Puerto Rican, all that old stuff, Mexico, Haiti, all over in that area from America, which is called South America. They took them over there. And so what you get is a half Spaniard person or a half white person, just like over in this country with mixed people, you know what I mean? But one drop of blood, you mine. You belong to me. So Puerto Rican, I see you with your dark skin. Latinos with your dark skin, you mine. Even though you're not psychologically you're not black, but biologically you are. Psychologically, you say you Spanish, but that one drop of blood rule means that you're black. So you might have their straight hair, whatever, whatnot, We don't know because you know different Africans got different strains of color in hair too. There's people Cardi B's complexion in Africa that's never been touched by white people. True indeed. We got people in Africa that look like the Chinese, but the Chinese really look like them. There's a tribe over in Africa right now with the eyes and the complexion, never been touched by white people or Chinese people. So in actuality, everybody come from black people, whether you believe it or not. But Candace Owens went on to chop the sister off, talked about her vagina, that she's not a good role model for black women. Hey, I agree that Cardi B needs to come a little bit more educational with her music, because she do have a platform and you have a responsibility as a Latino and black person. So give the girls, you know, this is all I got to say. Give the girls something else to look up to, because they ain't got to take their clothes off to be intelligent. I mean, intelligent black women, Latino women, white women. Women are intelligent. They don't. Some women turn me on by just being smart as they are, or just their goofiness. You know, women don't have to take off their clothes to be attractive. So let's nip that in. I'm not saying I'm riding for Cardi B against Kendall's on, because to me, they're on the same platform to me. You know what I'm saying? But do you got to, you know, tear somebody down like that to disagree? I mean, you talked about the girl vagina. She's not black. Her mama, her daddy. I mean, you dogged her all the way out. And she trying to back up by like, look, I'm not into politics like that. You know what I mean? But I'm just getting my opinion. And I seen the interview with Cardi B, and I agree that needs to be a law mandated if the government give a fuck about black people. Anytime a cop kills any citizen, whether white, black, Puerto Rican, that they should face the same penalty as me and you. If me and you kill someone, we going to jail. We going to jail. Nine times out of ten, we going to be so broke and our bail going to be so high, we ain't going to be able to make it. We're going to ask our mamas and our peoples to put their fucking house up to get us out. And 9 times out of ten, if we guilty of the murder, we going to jail for a long time. Police kill people and get short time. What are they? Amber Guyton, whatever her name was. Was that Houston or somewhere? Where that? Somewhere Texas, I think. Where she shot the man eating a bowl of ice cream, watching football. She only get 10 years. I take 10 years from killing one of these motherfucking popos. And I'm talking about the bad police. I ain't talking about just going out here shooting the police that's doing good. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about motherfucking police that didn't kill someone and someone's family. I take 10 years, but not now. I'm older now. But back in the day when I was young, I take 10 years. I done did too much time in the joint. And I done see, and racism came to me when I can digest it, because I was older. You know, when racism came at me at 12 years old, when I told y'all, when I broke into a school and I was running and I got caught by the sheriff and he called me all kind of niggers. He was telling me a story how he shot a black man in the back of the head and the bullet came out his mouth and the black little boy survived, but he couldn't testify against the cop because his vocals and stuff was messed up due to the injury. That's what he told me. And he called me all kind of niggers and he was a good looking white man. Why the fuck he should be chasing me? Why should I be chasing niggers? But I didn't digest it because I was young at 12, but I reflect back on it when I got a little older and I went to the big boy joint and I was getting out on the early release. And the white shirt guard that was taking me out, you know, get me dressed out. So the county, Montgomery County, come get me and take me back to the county to get me shock probation. I was getting out. My lawyer had got me out. Anyway, make a long story short, well, after I got all my property, I got up front and I got into a room, a little cell, a white guy come in with the white shirt that told me to get, you know, dressed and, you know, I'm ready to leave. He gets to push it on me. Stand up, nigger. He get to push. I'm a little guy, about like 19. I want to swing on this cracker. He's like, go ahead. You never get up out of here. You know, I think about my mom, my grandmother. My grandmother's lived at the time. She was upset that I was in the joint first time. She was worried about it, but he spit on me and everything, man. Called me all kind of niggas, and I started digesting it. You know, I still wasn't really wonder why he was doing that. What, because I was black? I just thought he was doing it because I was getting out and he was jealous, whatnot. Later on in life, I started, you know, getting it. You're black, and you're a black man, and you're a threat. And the younger you are when you're black, and I'm talking about, like, not when you're 6 or 7 or 8, they still don't like you then, but when you start getting that man look, that's when white people and white authority are scared of you, because my young brothers that's 19, 20, 23, 24, 25, I sympathize, which I know what you're going through, because it happened to me. Now that I'm old, they still treat me crazy. But I know when they get behind me and blow my tags up, this is a 50-year-old, let him go. If I was 20, they don't pull me over. They fear young black men. Okay. That's when I start catching on to racism later on. But anyway, Kansas Owens has no right to tear someone down the way she tear him down for Trump, when Trump is a cold-blooded racist. I don't know why all these people talking about Trump draining the swamp. He's not a racist. You know, Trump is a cold-blooded racist. I got the receipts. And if you pay attention to the things he say, you know, if you catch on to the things he say, and he's blunt with it, you will know that he a racist. But you got black people who love the white man so much, it's pitiful. And it started with that white Jesus. When they tricked niggas and told niggas that God was white, you know, that was over with. And that's why they run this world to this day, because of stupid niggas. Niggas have power. Black people have power. What I'm saying, we the ones that opened this world up to what it is today. We are the ones that had all the knowledge and the power when the European people lived in the caves of Europe. And I'm not being funny. White people lived in the caves of Europe, bruh. They came out them caves and ransacked the East, which was Africa. All of Africa, everything in the East was black land. These Arabs and all these other people that you see over there now came after invasions. I know y'all be like, he said the black man was the Egyptian, but when you turn on the TV, they show these pale-faced Egyptians. These are invaders, dumb nigga. These are invaders. They are conquering these lands that they're going in. That fucking place they call Israel over there, them not the real children of Israel. We are. We are the chosen people. Those people got there in 1943. Do your fucking history. The people in Israel came from out of Europe. The Rothschilds financed the people of color that lived on that land, which was Palestinians, and they got there by conquering, because all of what they call Israel today was black land. Y'all don't know that. The fucking, the 1943 war between the Palestinians and the British, the fucking French, everybody helped in that war to take over what you call Israel today. That's why Israel would never have any peace, because it's there as an invader, a conqueror. An Israeli is a conqueror. An Israelite is the original people of the land. Trust indeed. But back to what I'm saying, Kansas Owens, you have no right to talk about nobody. You disrespect George Floyd. You go out your way. Cardi B was right. How can you go out your way for white supremacy to condone to murder a George Floyd? You call it despicable. I don't give a fuck if he got a motherfucking criminal record. He didn't deserve to die the way he died. That was inhumane. And Cardi B, you got to know, you were speaking the truth. I got it back. You were speaking the truth about police genocide. But one thing that Cardi B, you can't speak for our people, unless you recognize that you are psychologically and biologically African or black. You didn't bring nothing up about reparations and voting. What do the black people get when they vote? So that's why I know it was some type of ploy to get us to vote for Biden. I'm not stupid. But I wouldn't go out my way to dismantle her because I disagree. I will come like Cardi B. I hear that you're speaking and want us to vote Democrat, but ask the Democratic Party, what do black people get from the vote? What do we get as a people? We got zero up under Obama. We getting zero up under Trump. If anybody cared about black people in the American government, if Trump really gave a fuck about black people in the American government, it would be a major intervention with these cops killing black people. Just like y'all say, man, they went to Iraq, man, to free Iraqi people from Saddam Hussein. Shut the fuck up. You don't know what the fuck you talking about. They went over there to take their oil. Take the revenue. The land is worth money. We don't understand that as a people, you know. That's what a revolution is fought about in each motherfucking war that you read about, the land. Because your land is the one to reproduce. Us as a black people, we don't get that no more. Why the fuck do you keep spending all your money with these white companies when you should be asking these white companies, slavery put you people in this position? Chase Bank is in a position that is in because of slavery. You don't even know your fucking research, man. I mean, you don't do your fucking research. Know your history, man. Everybody from the street is not dumb. It's people studying from the street. Streets watching, man, all the time. That's how I would come at Cardi B. Calling her bitches and talking about her pussy. All this, this, and that. Man, to disagree, I don't have to tear you down. I can tear down the person, the rotten-ass person that you're voting for and who you want us to follow. Now, I tear them motherfuckers down because them motherfuckers straight up evil. Everything that they do, they move evilly. Every move, a strategic move they make is to take black people down and poor people down. In order for the government or in order for the government, what could I say? In order for capitalism to exist, it must suck the blood of the poor to stay in its position. So, with that being said, Cardi B has no reason to be torn down by Candace Owens the way she talked about her. And I'm pretty much sure, I'm not even going to show y'all no video, because y'all can look it up yourself, and you realize that this lady, Candace Owens, is so infatuated with white people, she has a real low self-esteem. She comes out with venom against poor people, anybody that's Democratic, that's black. Why is it your job when somebody come out of color for you to come out and attack them? You don't say nothing if, let's say, Taylor Swift, even though she don't got nothing to do with American politics, let's say Taylor Swift and Joe Biden sat down and she was talking in favor of the Democratic Party. Would she have came out and said anything? No. Her job is to attack black people. That is Candace Owens' job. I'm telling y'all, man, in this 21st century right now, you got so many black people that hate themselves, they're ready to align with their fucking oppressor to kill themselves. That's suicidal. You can talk about me, say I'm crazy, and everything. I got people in my family think I'm crazy, but I love me that much and my people that I would never go against us to kill us off and say stuff out the way that make it look as if We're nothing, so I'm going to give white supremacy a leverage. Ain't nobody going to say nothing. I'm going to give them a leverage to keep trying to annihilate us off the planet, physically, mentally, spiritually. Just kill us off. And that's what they're trying to do. And that's what COVID-19 was created to do, is to kill people of color off, but it flipped. It's killing everybody. Don't you believe that the African-American community is suffering from COVID-19? A whole bunch of people are suffering for COVID-19, not only black people. This disease and curtail itself and started attacking everybody. And that what was the problem. And that's why Trump kept it to a muffle. He knew that this disease was here. People was dying of a strange flu. Y'all might not believe this. Trump cannot stop COVID-19. Y'all, I'm telling y'all, look up the Rockefeller Lock State Foundation. I'm not going to keep putting videos up after videos up and showing y'all stuff, knowing that y'all know that these people purposely created this disease. So Trump knew it was here. It all came out. Y'all seen it in the news. Y'all heard the videos, his voice. I went off that. I don't really go off what NBC, ABC, CBS, the mainstream media say. I take this shit, I break down, I analyze, I take the good shit out of it and leave the lies aside. And that's how I look at shit. Because everything on the news is not true. We got people in this country, especially our people, they so manipulated. Everything that comes on TV, they believe it. But that's what they said on CBS. You don't know what you're talking about, nigga. You from the west side of Dayton, nigga. You don't know what the fuck you talking about, nigga. You from the streets, nigga. You just a nigga. You know, that's another thing. Most black people think black people are stupid. When we gave creation to a lot of things in existence that your ass use today, such as electricity, the fucking stoplight. You know, the Europeans or the white people in this country used to kill each other with their cars. They didn't have enough nonsense to know, you got to let this car go. Bye, man. You gotta have a stop sign or something to let this car go, or we gotta take turns. You know, they didn't have that type of fucking nonsense. Do your research, because y'all think we stupid. The white men call it nigger rigging, because something break, and we always know how to fix it. You know, we do what we do. We might not put it back together as the manufacturing people do it, but we'll find a way to put that bitch together and make shit work. I used to do that shit. I don't know where I get that from. You know, my stepfather had a reel-to-reel that didn't work, and he had one that did work. He gave them to me. I got to get in there. I did something. I made it work. So that's how we are as a people. We genius people. All I do is go back and do my ancient history. That's where I draw my strength from. When I said when we was rulers in Africa, fuck American history, all the achievement that we got. Not to say fuck that, but that just proves to me how smart and how dominant the black mind is once you put it to work. What I'm saying is that no matter what field you put a nigga in, we goddamn it, we take over it. You know, we do it to the expertise. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what type of motherfucker we is. And me going back looking at Mansa Musa, the richest man in the world. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking at Hannibal the Great. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Ethiopian King. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, just doing all kind of research, seeing how we were as a people before we bumped into the white man. Before we ran into and had a collab with him, we was on top of the world. We was presidential, like the president. We just didn't rule like that. We had a society where the woman and the man was equal. We didn't have it until where the woman was down here and the man was up here. We just, you know, the woman was regarded as our strength, our God in a sense. But anyway, Candace Owens, she's going to come out and attack LeBron James. Anybody that speaks against Trump, you know, I mean, she's vulgar. I mean, it's like you can see the hate that she has for herself. And she hates black men so much. That's why she's married to a white boy. A white boy studied his ancestors and his ancestors from Europe, and they enslaved black people. She in love with her slave masters. So we got to turn her off, turn all these celebs off, because they come up with these hats, vote. What do we get from a black vote? Ice Cube, I commend Ice Cube, the brother Ice Cube. He got a contract for black people, for white America, the government. This is what we want if you get our vote. Me, I want to get paid for the lynching, the enslavement, the incarceration, all the shit you took my people through and still taking my people through. When police kill us, they get no time. And when they do get locked up, they get special treatment. And I think it's wrong. You see what they did to that black cop, though? They sent that nigga to jail. He shot that woman by accident. Sent that nigga to jail. I think he got like 12 years for that shit. White cops ain't getting no time. They getting out that shit still. You might have a few there, one or two. I seen that they gave some time too, but they getting right back out here. And hailed as a hero. Cardi B goes on to say with Joe Biden that police should go to jail like everybody else, like you and me. And I agree. You kill someone that doesn't have a knife, doesn't have a gun. Hell, a motherfucker with a whaling knife, a motherfucking brick or whatever, and I got a gun, I shoot you in your leg. I ain't got to kill you. I shoot you in your leg. You ain't no threat. Have you ever heard this? Never took a knife to a gunfight? Come on, man. I shoot you in your motherfucking leg. I ain't got to kill you. I can shoot you in the air. Shoot in the air. You drop that knife. But police are trained to kill. They're not trained to subdue a person and bring them in without killing them, unless you white. If you white with a gun, you done kill 30 motherfuckers. Somehow the police can get you in custody without harm coming to you. Shit, De La Rue in Carolina kills 9 people. They took him in and took that nigga to Burger King. They took that white boy to Burger King after he killed 9 black people and then took him to the jail. So that showed you in this country that no one loves you as black people. So what's wrong with y'all uniting? Fuck Candace Owens. Fuck her. She made her decision when she gets on all her platforms and destroyed black men. She want all black men to be killed off. Ahmaud Arbery, minding his own business, running, jogging, get killed. She sanctioned the white boys for doing that. She sanctioned them. What I mean about that, she condoned it. She came out and spoke like, you know, against the brother that's dead. So this bitch has no right. I'm calling her a bitch. This bitch has no right to come out and speak against Cardi B when you hate black men. Cardi B dates black men. Cardi B is more blacker than you. And I'm not taking up for Cardi B because I think Cardi B should be a better influence with black women and black girls. Everybody wants to be Cardi B on the female side. Instagram ain't nothing but pretty black women on Instagram. You go to Instagram, you find all the pretty black women, and they imitating who? So, I'm not giving Cardi B props, but she did say some good shit with Biden, made Biden back up. Like, whoa. I don't know if this was a staged interview, but I find it to be a good interview. She said some stuff that I would have said to Biden. But I wouldn't sit down with none of them because I already know the genetic makeup and what their position is and why you have the American government. The American government was made to keep black people at the bottom. And that's due to genetic survival. That's another video, another topic that I want to talk on, genetic survival. I made a couple of them. People don't view them. Because you got other YouTubers out here that may be a little bit more educated on that topic. Plus, the government want to keep me to a muffle. But like I said before, Cardi B has, you know, she has done something to Candace Owens. The Candace Owens is so infatuated with taking up for Trump. She made a video almost every other day attacking Cardi B. Cardi B like, look, man, I don't want no smoke. You know what I'm saying? Because all you do is we already hip to you. Cardi B is already hip to you. Black people, we already hip to you. Candace Owens, keep sucking white dick. Stay out of black people's situations. Speak for white people. That's who you speak for. Don't speak for me. Don't speak for my little sisters. Don't speak for my little brothers. Don't speak for black people, period. We don't know you. You don't know us. Candace Owens, keep your mouth off black people, because somebody going to put something in your mouth. I'm not threatening you, but somebody going to shut your mouth up. Leave us alone. Candace Owens. Hey, Streets watching. Drop a comment below and donate to my Cash App, man, so we can make this channel do what it do. Streets watching. I'm gone.